Yo, what is up, gamers? It's Sebastian here with another deck profile. We're here with Harry.
Hello.
And what deck did you decide to play for the YCS?
For the first remodule YCS, I tend to go to the only decent deck I have and play Dragolink.
Okay. And
still good copy.
And how do you do?
Surprisingly good enough. I went 8-3 and I misplayed the last round, so I could have gotten 9-2, but it's officially 8-3, good enough record from a decent deck from a bad player.
Yeah, okay. Do you want to get into the deck profile then?
Yeah. So starting with the main deck, we have the 9 hand traps I played, which are 3 as Blossom. This is pretty much the same as explaining why you play Pot of Greed in your deck. It's a card that always comes up. You never regret drawing it. The only time it's bad is when you draw more of them and you have no play. But it hits everything, especially the rock decks which I counted a few. So yeah, is an obvious choice. Effect Veiler. This is a budget Imberm, but it works very well with my deck because, as you can see, I play Chaos Ruler and Levanir and the Chaos Babies. So having a light in your graveyard isn't a bad thing, and you can always search it. Then I play three Phantasme. I have a lot of reasons why I play this card, and I will not blame you for cutting it. Maybe I would cut it as well for maybe Bell or a Droll. But the theory behind it was that it is, first of all, a Dragon, a Dark, and a level 7, and a 2400 bitter. It also fixes your hand, which sometimes can be pretty bricky. So you can see either your Veilers and your Ashes, or a hand make your hand good enough to play for the interruption. The fact that it protects against targeting is really handy against the boogeyman of the format being Striker that came back with Engage. So they really had either asked this card or they pretty much lost to it.
Yeah.
There is a neat interaction with Seifert and Noctovision, which if you go first and you draw this, you can send it to search for the Noctovision and go into your link to this way by drawing a card and searching it. Now I will go back to this later. But for now, continuing with the main dragons of the deck, we have the Rockets, which are 2 Synchron, 2 Tracer, and 1 Recharger. 2 Synchron because there are times it's pretty much your Hulk Summon, so, sometimes you need that to be live, and also there are times where you draw Recharger and Synchron your hand, and it just helps having these three makes Tracer always alive. 2 Tracer because you can search it, and seeing multiples isn't the best, but it isn't the worst thing either. So I think the ratio is good here. Also have the Absol Router, which is essentially the searcher. Send it off Ravine, search any rocket you need. And 90% of the time it's Tracer. Then we have the two Seifert. I was thinking playing three, but it is a normal summon. But I already have three other normal summons, and having two feels just the right amount. You use it to get your Levanir back in motion. It's a light and searches your Chaos Dragons to go into link to this way, the most basic, I guess, comb of the deck. Now we have two Chaos Dragons, three special summon, a light dark one such as the other. Possibly the best two cards that make the deck playable together with Chaos Space. Then we have the big Chaos Dragon being Levanir, my favorite card probably in the deck. This helps fill the spots of the blind spots of the deck, being a removal, limiting the hand of your opponent by shuffling a card turn one. The third effect never comes up really, which being the reborn one. But it is probably the card that helps you win in the grind game. Gets looped back by Safer. All around, probably the best, one of the best cards of the deck. Then we have the Noctovision Dragon. You play so many Dark Dragons, it triggers almost any time you draw it. Also, 13 cards of your 15 are dragons in your extra deck, so you can trigger the draw effect pretty easily. And because, as you will see, I play Tiding, it has a neat third effect that protects your shortcut by being its Cosmic Cyclone on MST, which is funny but didn't come up in this weekend. Next we have Brotar. Searches Levanir almost all the time, helps you from not dying, and just is good in the grind game, facilitates your backup plan. Then we have the Metal and the Red MD. I play this because you can summon it off spheres, and it doesn't really hurt normal summoning it, as you most of the time as you like seeing the Red MD into rotation. And finally, we have two Chamber Dragon Mates. This is the other normal summon of the deck, which conflicts with Safer when you draw both of them. So I feel playing two of these, one Metal and two Safer, feels pretty normal. The card that our target is only Tiding, and the card is just insane. This would, together with Spheres, are just two bounds, and most combat decks can't really play even through that. Not to mention that Tiding has a second effect, which is which helps your backup. Next, for the spells, we have 3 Chaos Space, pure advantage. You can make a link to and still have 4-5 cards in your hand without even normal summoning. If you draw it and this gets through, you pretty much have your combo. Wodakashika Dragon. This card in this version is kind of strong. Because it's kind of strong and helps you make peace team, especially now that you don't have many link hours to make your Gun Dragon combo live. Next we have three quick launch. It's summons a rocket, doesn't get effects. The only downside is that it gets thrown in the end phase and cannot attack. The one called By the Grave, even going second, it is a really good card. In the mirror match, you hit seals and they cannot do anything. You hit Ray, you hit Handrap. I think I hit two or three draws with this, or a Handrap. Just really good to see it. And next, you have the two searchable field spells, being Sector and Ravine. Strike a Dragon, Romulus.
Yeah.
Finally, we have the two traps, two Tiding. I feel two is the right amount because you search one, summon next turn, banish it, summon Tiding, search the other. And you don't really want to see either two of them or maybe even one of them. It feels kind of breaky. Next, for the extra deck. This is very much still up in the air since you lost three of your best link on monsters, but we have one Strike a Dragon, Yeah. It's sad, I know. Two pistis. It's a link one that that if you want to, don't want to waste your second dragon, you can just go into this with a baby with the babies, and save one for the next turn. With next you have two spheres. So there are times where you don't when you even turn three, you cannot even make a board, so you just seals pass again. It's not a bad thing, but seals bounce back a card, gives you summons any dragon from the deck. And helps you plays around Nibiru in a way. You could probably play three, but I didn't have on me, so I went for two and didn't really regret it. Now for the other link twos, we have Quad Borel, helps make the either one or the second level 8 synchro by special summoning the rockets. Romulus sets Ravine. Khalji Firebrax, helps you go into your link force, and yeah, it doesn't really come up often since it blocks up your extra monster zone for spheres, but as a turn 3 option, it's really solid, and there are always times where you might need one. This probably will seem weird. Triple best dragon. Three new spots in the deck, so you may as well use them.
That's
another cool thing. It has two effects, apart from being a generic link three. Damage step when an effect is activated, being gray, or in my case, a Cosmo card. I don't know how that came up, but it came up. Negate activation, and you play. Most of the times, you are in position where you just have a level 4 dragon. You make it pisty. You summon any monster, or Hulk summon an ass, and you just link it to triple burst, reborn any monster with pisty, and link them both of them off for seals, since they are both dragons.
Yeah.
Next, we have the two link fours, Apollos and Bolus Odd. I think it came up once, Apollos. Still isn't bad to play by any sense of the imagination. But you really need the follow up, so Spheres is nine times out of ten the a better boss. Bolus Odd closes games. Access code. I do not either own access code or think it's a good choice in the deck, since you cannot really make go into him with pisty. Also, about sword helps with a pisty arrows a bit, so that's a cool neat thing. And yeah, runs over almost everything and OTKs. Finally, for the synchros, I play four of them. Three being the classic Savage, Kyozle, Hot Red. Savage is a classic boss monster. It's a negate. Kyozle gives insane follow up. Like your meals can save your game. The reborn is an insane effect. And then you can use Rocket Synchron to go to your other synchro boss monster, that being Hot Red. It has a targets on a card and gets its effects, which is bad against Vitra Gold, but good against cards that that are hard ones better activates and not effects.
Yeah, like Fusion.
Yeah, not like that. Or I guess Meltdown or other stuff.
Yeah.
Also, a cool little detail, if it does battle damage, you can reborn a tuner from your graveyard, that most of the times that being Tracer or Synchron. So you can do some more cool stuff in the main phase too. And lastly, this is flex spot, but I played Skylight Red Archfiend, and that's purely for time. I did not know what to expect. There was a lot of Sky Striker, and just having an insurance, it always helps you not panic. I guess it never came up. Maybe the effect is kind of decent. Yeah, I was playing Xanathan before this, and Xanathan really doesn't come up, and when it comes up, that you doesn't really do much. And now, lastly, for the side deck, we have for the monsters, Pagrotops. It came up and won me games. I even popped a Tickaboo once against a Striker player. It was game over from that. Trinibiru, I set it in 2 times, and one time I drew it against a Vitzogod player. I nuked the board, they passed, I OTK'd. I do not mind playing this card, really handy. And 3, Jizukiru. I do not play Droll, I will explain a bit. But as for Jizukiru, I hate Ignisters with a burning passion. So we just tribute over the boss. I played 0 against 0. Also, against Vitzogold, you tribute Sensen because you need your graveyard. Tributes over Dragoon. Tributes over a problem card. I play this because it's a light. You could play either the other the Thunder Kaiju or Radiant because it's a dark and a light.
Yeah.
It's a bit problematic because attack stat is very high. But that it didn't really become a struggle to out it that much, and it's overall a good card. So and I'm not playing Droll because Dragoling is a deck that still without Telpy, if it doesn't draw the right hand, it just steals passes, and you don't want your opponent to have a turn 3 play. So you prefer having them lose the resources by virtue of Nibiru, for example, other than having them just stall them out for one turn with Droll. Still a good card, just the deck don't feel confident playing Droll. Also, Droll is a light. Droll is a wind. It's not a chaos card. So, yeah, but bad card. Don't play it. Don't use Droll against me, please. Next, we have background removal. 3 twisters, 1 feather duster. And of course, a red reboot. Twisters. I had access to Storm, but I prefer this card because it works in the standby phase. And you really don't want to face either a Winda or against a Battle Butler. It came up, this exact same thing came up in my last game, but I misplayed and I lost it anyways. But if I didn't play it, then I would have lost without even misplaying. Harpies, yeah, blows up the back row, and red reboot, and gets the traps. Isn't really that good in a Striker format because all of their back row spells. But when you play against Rogue, it pretty much wins to the game if they play Monkey like really simple floodgates like Tickaboo, Summon Limited, etc. And lastly, for going first, we have 3 Undispel Fragments. It's a good against Striker. It helps not getting Dark Ruler because your deck still hurts by that. And I do not play Order because most of the time your backup plan are your spells, that being Sector, Ravine, or anything, or Chaos Space, or even Wiglons, like or World Legacy. Like any spell is a good spell. Yeah. And you don't really want to top deck it while you have this act on the field. Even though you can really bounce it or pop it with a bunch of the spheres or pop it with a Levineer, it still helps having your spell set and then activate next turn so you can do your plays. And that's it.
Do you have any last words or shout outs you'd like to do?
So last words. The deck is still pretty much viable. By the time this video has come out, I think there are two Dragonlink tops in the NA and the EU YCS. So that proves that a good player, not me, can still perform really well. Even went 8-3, Seb went 8-2 with 8-2-1 with a different version of the deck.
Yeah.
So it's still a pretty good choice. Do not sell your decks if you like playing it. from SAT, I don't have much of a SAT out. I guess I have shout out to Seb because I crafted the deck while talking to him on stream. So thanks, Seb.
Yeah, you guys should check out my stream by the way, twitch.tv/Seb2360. And that's going to be it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. And if you liked the video, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you gamers later.